In this video, we take a look at some real Python programs and look at how you can identify syntax, logic, and runtime errors. So perhaps one of the best ways of demonstrating this is to actually write a program and talk about the syntax and logic errors within it. So in our code window on the left, we're going to write a very simple program that's going to present the user with three choices for a typical menu. And we're going to be examining the logic and syntax errors that we're creating inadvertently in this program. So here's the program, and you can see option one is to play a new game, option two is to save a game, and option three is to play the game. Now, we also want a little bit of validation in our program. We don't want it to accept invalid inputs. So we're going to say, while choice is greater than the string 1 and choice is less than the string 3, and we're using strings because it makes the validation a little bit more robust, we can then say the choice equals input enter choice and prompt the user for a choice. We'll give our program a run. And we can see we've got an error in the line that says PRNT, so that's line 3, play game. And we can see this is an example of a syntax error. The program wouldn't run because the command PRNT was not recognized. We, of course, have misspelt it. It should be print. So we've just corrected line 3 there to use the correct command print. So we just simply give that a save and a run again and see what happens. Okay, so this time it's saying that the name choice is not defined. So we're using the choice variable in our while statement here before we've assigned it a value, and Python doesn't like that. So we're going to add a line here, choice is equal to 0, giving the variable a value for the very first time before assigning that variable is good practice, and we should be doing that. It generated a syntax error in this case because it didn't recognize the variable choice. So let's save our program and run it again and see what happens. Okay, so we've got it running. So any errors from this point must be logic errors. Because the program is running, it must be syntactically correct. So we're going to try and play a new game. So that's option one. Oh, well, okay, we can't. It never actually offered us the choice. It simply printed out the menu commands. So that must mean we have a logic error in our statement that is doing the validation. So here we're saying, while choice is greater than 1 and choice is less than 3, offer me the choice. Okay, so it could possibly be that we've got our inequality operators the wrong way around here. That's the greater than or less than, and that's quite a common mistake. So you can see I've changed those around now, so we'll give it another save and a run and see what happens. Well, we end up with a very similar logic error happening here. We're still not getting presented with the ability to enter a choice, and it's because I'm using an AND here in the while statement instead of an OR. So we're just going to change that over to an OR, and let's save it and give it a run one more time. So now I'm being prompted to enter my choice, and I'm going to try an invalid input first. In this case, I'm going to press enter without entering anything at all and see what happens. So far, so good. The presence check is okay. It doesn't accept no input. It simply asks me to enter choice again. So now I'm going to try a data type check and enter a character here instead of a number. And it's fine with that. It's prompting me again to enter another choice. I'm going to try a few more invalid entries, such as a symbol, a negative number, and also a positive number above 3, which is outside the range we want. And again, it's absolutely fine. We're being stuck in the while loop, and it's still prompting me to enter a choice because I haven't entered one that's valid yet. So finally, let's try a valid option. So that's either 1, 2, or 3. And excellent, it's accepted it. So there we are. We've solved the problem in our program, the syntax errors and the logic errors. Now be careful here, just because our program has passed all the tests doesn't mean it's robust as it could be. We can see here if I enter 2.5, it's accepted it as if it's valid input. Of course, ideally, we'd like the program only to accept 1, 2 or 3. But if we check our while loop, it says while choice is less than 1 or greater than 3, then we carry on prompting to enter a choice. Well, that means any value entered between 1 and 3 is currently accepted. So there's still a way to go to make this program completely robust. So just to quickly recap for you, we've put on the screen the main information you need to know about syntax and logic errors, and some example of where both those types of errors can occur. So I've changed the Python program we're using on the left now, and we're going to consider runtime errors. So the first thing to note is the code on the left is free from syntax and logic errors, but that doesn't necessarily mean there won't be any runtime errors. In fact, this program does contain two runtime errors. The first is definitely going to cause the program to crash while it's running, and the second has the potential to cause the program to crash while it's running. So let's have a look at what I mean by that. So the program starts off by asking the user what their name is, and I've typed in Craig. It then opens up a text file called myfile.txt. If it doesn't exist, it creates the file, and then it adds to it the word Craig followed by a new line character. It then asks what their age is, and again it adds that value to the text file on a new line, and then after this we close the file, and that's text_file.close. The user then gets told to press enter to output the contents of the file. The program then opens the file, prints out the contents to the screen, which you can see it's done. And then it hits this line where we do print the result of 9 divided by 0. And you can see we've got a runtime error, 0 division error. And that's because computers can't divide by 0. It's an invalid calculation. The actual expression, as I've written it in the Python program, is perfectly valid. Number divided by number. This is a syntactically correct way of writing the expression. But when the actual calculation is carried out by the program using the values given, it causes a runtime error. Now, there's no reason to put this calculation at the end of this program. I've just done it so you can see the example of this runtime error. So that was the error which will always occur. But it was the only one that occurred. So we're going to run through the program again and show you how we could cause a second runtime error. So we've executed the first few bits of the program. We've asked what the name is, we've asked what the age is, so Craig, 41. They've been written into the text file, myfile.txt, and the text file's been closed. And the user's now been told to press enter to output the file. So that means on my computer there literally is a file, a text file called myfile.txt, and it contains the lines Craig and 41. But the program is currently waiting for you to press enter before it does anything else. What would happen if I then navigated to that text file and simply deleted it? So that's what I've actually done on my system. I've deleted the file, and now I'm going to press enter so the program carries on executing. Well, we hit the next line of code that says text files equals open myfile.txt, and of course we get a runtime error, file not found error, no such file or directory. And this is a classic example of a runtime error. The file did exist, but when it went to open it, it had then been deleted. This is why we didn't get the error the first time we ran through this program. Now, although this error might not occur all the time, and may be difficult to spot, a good programmer when writing a robust system would make sure to check the file existed before trying to open it. This was slightly beyond the scope of what we expect to do at GCSE, but it is an example of how programmers can make their program more robust by anticipating the sort of runtime errors they might have and writing code to handle it. So in summary, a runtime error is an error which causes the program to crash while it's running. Some good examples are illegal calculations, not being able to read or write to a file that's needed, possibly attempting to communicate to a device which is offline, and examples of buffer overflow.